Hi, is it possible to create a command in your own name in AutoCAD? Yes, it's possible. For that, you have to learn AutoLISP programming. What exactly is AutoLISP? AutoLISP is an inbuilt programming language that comes along with the normal AutoCAD software. So you may be thinking, is there any other version of AutoCAD? Yes, there is another version called AutoCAD LT, which is the basic AutoCAD software. And you cannot find AutoLISP programming in AutoCAD LT. And if you can learn and master AutoLISP programming, you can do so many things using AutoCAD software. You can customize the software because, as you know, AutoCAD has got open architecture. I have created few applications using AutoLISP programming. I'll talk about that later. In this video, I'll explain a very simple but a very useful application of AutoLISP program. Using this program, you can dimension any complex curvilinear objects. Before proceeding further, I request all of you to subscribe to my YouTube channel SabirCAD if you haven't subscribed already, and hit the bell icon to get instant updates on my future video uploads. So all these things and more is coming up, so stay tuned. I have opened AutoCAD software and I'll create three objects using polyline. So I'll click on polyline command and I'll create a straight line here. Next, I'll give a right click polyline again to repeat this command. This time I'll create an arc. So this is a start point, then right click, go to arc option, then a right click and choose second point option. This is the second point and this is the end point. Then right click and enter. So this is an arc which is made with polyline command. Next, again, I'll repeat the polyline command. This time I'll create a zigzag line like this. Okay. Now I'll click on polyline edit command, or else you can type the letter PE for polyline edit. Then select this polyline. Now you will get a number of options. I'll choose fit to create a smooth curve like this, which will pass through all the vertices of a polyline. So I have got three different objects which are made with polyline commands. Now I would like to dimension these objects. In order to perform this dimension, I'm not going to make use of the conventional method of using the annotate tab, but instead I'll use a LISP program. This particular file which you see on my desktop is called dimcurve.vlx. VLX will be the extension of the LISP program. Now I've kept the link to download this program at the description section of this video. In fact, this program is developed by CAD Studio. If you want to execute a LISP program, you have to first load it. So click on Manage tab, then click on Load Application, then select the desktop because I've kept it on the desktop. Then I'll select this particular file. Loading is a process of bringing a file from the hard disk to the memory so that it can be executed. When you load an AutoLISP program, it can be loaded in two different ways. You can load it once and it can be executed in this session of AutoCAD. Next time when you open AutoCAD, you have to again reload to access this program. In the second type of load, you can click on the startup suite and you can add the path wherein I have kept this particular AutoLISP program, so that every time you load AutoCAD, this particular program will get automatically loaded. Now I'm not going to do that, but instead I load this program only in this AutoCAD session. So I'll click on load. So it'll ask you whether you want to load it always, that is the startup loading, or load it once and do not load. I'll click on load it once. Now you have got a message, dimcurve.vlx successfully loaded. Now let me execute this command. The name of the AutoLISP file will be the name of the command. Here the file name is dimcurve, so I'm going to execute the dimcurve command. Now it will ask you to select the object dimension. I have kept this. Now I am asked to specify the dimension curve offset, which is nothing but the dimension line location. When you look at the dimension, you can see that the size of the dimension is a bit small. So let's scale the dimension. For that, you just click on the annotate tab and click on the arrow at the lower right corner of the dimension panel. Now click on modify and click on the fit tab and change the use overall scale of dimension to 2.5. And I'll give OK and close. You can see that the size of the dimension got changed. Now I'll again execute the dim curve command. Select this particular dimension and give an enter to execute the continue option and click a point to define the dimension curve offset. Now this is a curvilinear dimension. Now let's dimension this fit polyline. Again dim curve and select this object. Select a point to define the dimension curve offset, which is here. Now you have even got the dimension of this particular complex curve. Now let's see few options in the dim curve command. But before exploring this option, I would like to activate the dynamic mode. You're already aware that when this dynamic mode is on, any user input given will appear at the cursor location. Now I'll just right click and go to recent input and choose a dim curve command. Now it will ask you to select the curve to dimension. I'll choose this arc. Now the options will appear at the cursor location since the dynamic mode is active. I'll click on linear, then I'll click on continue. Now you can get either a vertical or a horizontal dimension between the selected points. It's similar to the linear dimensions which you normally perform. Next, I'll right click and repeat dimension curve. I'll choose this arc and this time I'll choose aligned. When you choose aligned and click on continue, you will get the aligned dimension or the inclined dimension. It's similar to the aligned dimension which you normally perform. Hope this video was informative. Please hit the like button of this video if you liked it. I can teach you AutoLISP if you are ready to learn. Watch out for my upcoming videos in AutoLISP. Until I catch you in the next video, bye bye and take care. May God bless you all.